all who come to this happy place, welcome. Disneyland is your land. Here aid relives.
That is Walt Disney on July 17, 1955, opening day at Disneyland. The success of the Southern California park helped launch the modern theme park industry. But the concept of the amusement park dates back centuries. The story is detailed in the new book, The Amusement Park, 900 Years of Thrills and Spills and the Dreamers and Schemers Who Built Them by Steve Silverman. Don Dahler joined the author to hear about that wild ride.
Why do you think we love these roller coasters?
It's the speed, it's the challenge, it's the daredevil.
Oh, there we go.
Those stomach-turning drops and heart-pounding twists and turns have been woven into one of America's favorite pastimes for decades.
So why a book about amusement parks? Have you just always loved them?
Yes.
Where most find thrill in the dips and dives of these rides, author Stephen M. Silverman finds excitement in their history.
How old is this business?
The 12th century, 1133, Bartholomew Fair in England. But the oldest one in the world today is in Denmark, and it's more than 400 years old. It's called Bakken.
And it's still operating?
It's still operating. To survive, an amusement park has to keep offering something new.
A sales tactic discovered early on by the so-called greatest showman, P.T. Barnum. In the 1840s, he started his first attraction in Lower Manhattan, Barnum's American Museum.
He really added pizzazz to a world that didn't have it. And he was a master of publicity, that we know, but also he perfected advertisement. He said, I have a Fiji mermaid. Well, it was a dead fish with, I think, a monkey's head sewn on. And then he would go and advertise it. In the city, you would see placards for the Fiji mermaid. Well, it was a bare-breasted, beautiful mermaid.
Right. A little bit of not taking liberties with the advertising.
Not what you got to see inside.
While Barnum knew how to put spectators on an emotional roller coaster, it was Catherine the Great who was credited for creating the first physical one almost 60 years earlier.
She's the empress of roller coasters, really. And then when the French soldiers were over for the War of 1812, they saw these Russian slides. They're called Russian mountains even to this day in Europe. Well, they took it back with them to Paris, where they got the idea of adding wheels. But it stayed in Europe. It didn't transfer over to the United States. The fellow who came up with it was a former garment manufacturer and tinkerer named Lamarcus Thompson.
Thompson built the first patented roller coaster in the U.S. in 1884. It was designed after an old mine train.
He introduced what was called the switchback railroad. It only went 6 miles an hour. It only went 600 feet. And that was the first, and it was right here.
Right here is on New York City's Coney Island, home to other amusement firsts. In 1829, the beachside resort, first of its kind, opened.
Take a bite.
And 90 years later, Coney Island made history again with the introduction of an American icon, the hot dog.
Nathan's is famous, but it wasn't the original Coney Island hot dog?
No, it was Charles Feltman who came up with the recipe. But Nathan worked for him. He used to slice his buns. Feltman's hot dogs were a dime, and Nathan said, I'll sell mine for a nickel, and called them famous before they were.
While Coney Island is the birthplace of the American amusement park, the 1893 Chicago World's Fair brought to life the possibilities of what a theme park could be.
Chicago World's Fair honored science and achievements in academia and industry. But for the first time, a World's Fair had a dedicated fun zone. And that was the real hit of the fair. That's what made the money for the fair. And it was seen that this could be transferred. So it was the Chicago World's Fair that launched everything.
Everything, including a larger-than-life, never-seen-before ride, considered to be the eighth wonder of the world.
The Ferris wheel in Chicago was enormous, and it really wasn't until a terrible storm had blown through the fairgrounds in Chicago that people felt it was safe enough to ride.
Grossing the equivalent of $20 million in today's economy, the Ferris wheel made the Chicago Fair a success and created a new demand for amusement parks across the country. But the boom was short-lived.
Then came the Depression, everything went to hell. And after the war, television came in. Nobody was interested in going to amusement parks. But then came a very clever guy who knew what to do with television. And his name was Walt Disney. And he revolutionized everything.
In 1955, Disneyland opened to the public, only 6.5 miles away from the already established Knott's Berry Farm. While that park took visitors back in time to the Wild West, Disneyland offered visitors something new, a glimpse into the future.
It took a couple of decades for them to really get the formula, but now amusement parks are part of our fabric.
Where does the industry see its future growth?
The American parks are going gangbusters, especially Disney and Universal. For the first time, they're rivals. Universal has Harry Potter, Disney has Star Wars, but also the Six Flags parks are doing very well.
As is the original Coney Island. At the reimagined Luna Park, which features thrill rides, as well as an old amusement park staple, the carousel.
Carousels have never been the most exciting of rides, but why have we always loved them?
Well, they're actually the first ride, and they all began as war games. This is how soldiers used to practice before they went into battle in the 12th century. What's significant, especially about this one, that shiny one was carved by Marcus Illions, who was considered the Michelangelo of carousel horse carvers.
Luna Park's president, Alex Zampella, says the key to success is respecting the park's legacy.
Grandfathers, grandmothers, you know, come here with their children, their grandchildren, and so on, and, you know, sharing that unique moment of the first drop when you're about to fall at, you know, close to 60 miles per hour, and then seeing, you know, their faces. The grandchildren so proud having kind of joined the club.
A club that makes us all feel like kids again.
It's all to take us out of whether your reality is grim. Even just a simple roller coaster. When you're at the top going down, you're not thinking about paying the mortgage.
That's so very true.
So true, right?
That was a lot of fun to watch.
You have a favorite?
Geauga Lake. It was in Cleveland, Portage County. Shout out to all the Clevelanders.
Yeah.
It fell into disrepair. I believe it shut down in like 2008, and then it turned into Six Flags at one point. Then Geauga Lake got it back, and it no longer exists, but it was like the hangout spot when I was like 14, 15.
Yep.
Mine was
loved
Cedar
it.
Point in Sandusky, which is still there, and you had to go in a certain order, and it was like you did the blue streak, and then once the demon drop was in action, you'd do the demon drop, and then you'd make your way to the Gemini, and then you'd hit the corkscrew in the middle there, so.
There's nothing like going to an amusement park with family or friends. It really does. It just takes you to a different
It's fantastic.
Different place.